getting here because it's Throwback Thursday, probably the best day of the week for lovers of classic. And ladies and gentlemen, today happens to be National Men Make Dinner Day. So today, men are supposed to be in charge of the kitchen. Maybe make dinner and spice things up with some good old school movies.
Oh, wow.
And music.
Wow, and what for this?
So are you going to make dinner for your many
girlfriends?
Dinner
for two.
So you're supposed to make dinner for your wife or your girlfriend. So it doesn't apply to people like
that. Yeah, but you said you have some girlfriends.
One. So I should just go and gather all of them too.
And now.
Gather them. It's
dinner
at my house.
Dinner for two, three, four, five. Pregnancy for
one person.
Anyway, guys, to be a part of the show, all you have to do is tweet to us at TVC Connect with the hashtag EastAsianTVC. You can call us as well. Yep, the numbers will be on the screen right about now. And you can catch in on all the excitement, all the thrills of the show on your internet-enabled devices. Just go to our website. It's tvcentertainment.tv. My name is Faladile, guys. Welcome aboard.
It's your girl. It's your home girl. It's the jewel in the crown. Of course, it's the hostess with the mistress. My name is Honey Potts.
And of course... Like,
sorry, Oji. Yeah? Hostess, mostess now?
Yeah. Is no, you can be the host with the most. Anytime I feel I say it's the hostess with the mostess.
If it's just your feeling, all right, got it. Thank you.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, mine doesn't change. This is Royal Ness Finest. I go by the name King OJ. Well, you could call me OJ. That's what it is. And of course, it is what it is.
And it will always be.
All right, today on the show, there is entertainment news coming up very soon. Celebrity birthday shout out. Then rewind, where we'll take you through a quick history lesson of today in entertainment history.
Right after that, I'll take us over to the Twoville corner for some humor and savagery from social media.
Then where are they now? Comes up right after, where you'll find out what your favorite Nigerian artist from way back are up to these days.
Yes, later we'll do some ranting on the treat of segments, then bring you a recap of all that you miss in the news. Then on Daily Top 5, we will be talking about 5 evergreen Nollywood movies. Right after that, it will be time for our Celebrity Top 10 Countdown. So let's get started already. It's Flash, we'll be back after this break.
Shout out to our Nigerian video directors, the modern day video directors. I was watching Timaya's video today. Oh my God.
Anyways, what kind of shout out?
Okay. Like,
yeah.
Like they're trying.
Yeah, they are
but
trying.
But it was what was available then and they tried their best. I mean,
yeah,
they did
yeah,
well.
Yeah, yeah. So our Nigerian video directors, music video directors, now we get to see a whole lot of shaky.
Okay.
A whole lot of nakedness and.
People were saying that time. Even the prostitutes walk close
yes.
from head to
and it was still sexy in a way.
Shook back then, yes. but we just didn't perceive it as something that
so
was.
So what
sexual.
You don't know, you don't know.
Yeah, mm-hmm. exactly.
Do you understand?
Exactly.
So that
now they have
it.
To be naked so that we'll get the point. Let's just
well,
move on.
It's time for entertainment news. And we start with this. Lizzy Evelme, aka Ovalaria, is not dead. Yesterday, we reported the news of the death of the new masquerade actress Lizzy Evelme, aka Ovalaria. There is a different twist to that story as our on-screen husband, Chika Opala, aka Chief Zebrudaya, has come out to state that she is not dead, but instead, the actress is currently suffering from arthritis as well as eyesight problem. Also debunking the rumor that was put out by Churchill Egbodage, another actor in the new masquerade sitcom, Tony Akposheri, who played the role of Zacchaeus, also confirms that she's not dead as he just had a phone call conversation with the actress. All efforts to get in touch with Lizzy Evelme's family and Chief Zebrudaya for further confirmation on the story have been proven abortive.
However, so just before we came on the show, we finally got through to someone from her camp, and they said that truly she is fine, and like as in she's alive, and she's supposed to make an appearance at the Afro happening this weekend. So we'll see how that goes. Yeah.
We'll keep our fingers crossed.
We will keep our fingers crossed.
We are happy that she's not, and while she's alive, we should just show her all the love that she needs at this point.
Yeah, it's so, but I mean, we can't move on without talking about the fact that it just sucks that. Because this happened the other day with, I think, was Sky B.
Yes.
And news of his passing came out, and then next thing.
Well, you should be sure that this is not a stunt. Somebody just cooked this up. I mean, yeah. This old woman, what does she...
And right, but that's the problem. Like, before you come out to... Because, the person who reported it, like, came out with so much authority, and everybody picked it up because, you know... well, she's alive, Shan. We're just happy about that.
That person wanted to train. It's
how
possible.
Will you trend with something
no,
like that?
No, because see, in this world, people use anything for clout. Look at Davido. You just heard that, the wife had been delivered of a baby.
Whiskey to clout, not...
No, the person to might be old school and be thinking, this thing that we're really, really, let's go and look
let's
for. We talked about it today, earlier today, when we said that sometimes, see, when people say, there is no smoke without fire or something, it's a lie. Sometimes some people just see you and they just cook a story up about you.
Crazy.
It's not as if you have been into something or you have done something. Some people, that is their job.
However, I think it's also possible, because with the Sky B thing, what had happened as well was that they saw him on set dying and thought that that was him dying in real life. So perhaps maybe this person had something and then thought
the sickness that she
so it's
through.
About clout. So that person wants to be the first person to put
to
it out, so that they'll say that and then they'll be referring to you and they'll be, and then you will trend, you'll have more followers and all that. People should stop that. It is just
because we can't report it without attributing the story to your name.
All right, moving on to some more exciting stories. Shatta Wale is apparently worth over $10 million. Yes, Ghanaian dancehall artist Shatta Wale has claimed that he's worth over $10 million. That is about 3.6 billion naira. He made this known in a recent interview with a Ghanaian-based radio station. He said it's not bragging, even though he's the richest musician in Ghana, but he talks about his wealth to motivate the youth to work hard like he did. He said, and I quote, "For now, I can say that I'm worth over $10 million. It is business, so if they will understand it like that, any other artist can speak the way I speak. But sometimes you ask Ghanaian artists whether they are rich, all they say is me, I don't disclose my worth because that is not a lie. Because that is a lie. Because when you watch the likes of Jay-Z, Kanye West and other big artists, when they buy a new house, they post it on the internet, so it is normal. It is not like I'm bragging to anybody, but it's also a motivation to the youth to believe in their dreams and work hard towards it." So Shatta Wale, my guy from Ghana, is... I know many artists tend to always shy off from putting out their worth outside, but Shatta Wale is that guy that doesn't even send anybody. People do it outside the country.
Fam, to say you're worth something, it's not that you can afford to buy something that is, as in to say that you are worth, like when they put out net worth online and you see that, like this, to make such a bold claim.
He has houses, he has cars.
Okay, no problem.
And he featured recently on Beyonce's project, so that's more money coming in. So
that's $10 million. Okay, cool. Well, my only question is, I would like to ask you guys, where do you draw the line between putting out your stuff, being boastful and putting out your stuff to motivate younger people? So how would you know if you perceive that? So perhaps you're on someone's page, maybe Jay-Z or Floyd Mayweather.
Like Jay-Z or Prestos yesterday.
Yes,
Jay-Z. It's even planning a show. The invite for that particular event was Rolex wristwatches. That was the invite.
So who did that a while ago? It was somebody, was it Tyler Perry inviting people the other day? That 50 Cent was invited and it was like, this person is, you know,
person. My question is, how do you, perhaps you're on Tyler Perry's page or someone, and you know he put out that he was chilling in his house that he finally built for himself. So how do you decide or decipher when that is bragging or boasting?
So people have always asked this question, especially when people do help others too, and they put it out. Williams Uchemba helping people recording it, Koku Foundation and recording it. People always say that when you do good, just do that recording. Good and be quiet about it. But they say that they do it so that people can know what's going on and, you know, they can help people and see how. So it depends on you, really, whatever rocks your boat, because we have been back and forth on this. And it's not as if you are running for a position and they're saying declare your worth. But then it can be very, very boastful. And we know that it is one of the reasons we are where we are, talking about social media pressure and all of this. So people see all of these things and some of them can't take it well. It's not as if they are bad people. It's not as if they are jealous, because you know that jealousy is the root of all hatred.
Wow. You knew that last, you still be deep.
Well, what I'm saying here is, the other day David B was here and I touched on when he said he was depressed, and he said yes, he went back to London and saw how his friends had made it and he just felt sad. Not that you're not wishing them well, not that you don't want to, but you're looking at your own life and thinking, where am I now and all of this. But in all, it is life. It is bound to happen. Do you get it? It is now for you to control how you take control everything. Your own self, how you take things in. Maybe you're going to be sieving the way you, because there is no how you open the internet and you not see all of these things. You just die.
But like you said, I mean, it's down to the person consuming the content, mm-hmm. because intention is something that we can never prove until we open people's hearts up. So you can't prove really if it's bragging or, you know, just motivation.
Shatta!
You know that Shatta loves to brag.
Eh? He does. Hey. But it's okay. It's motivating.
It's motivating, yeah.
All right, moving swiftly along to our final story. Kim Kardashian and Kanye West reach compromise over Kanye's religious beliefs. Ooh. TV reality star, Kim Kardashian, has given an insight into the changes that have occurred in her home since her husband, Kanye West, became born again. She made this known when she appeared on a recent episode of The Real. When she was asked if she supports her husband's new spiritual life journey, she had this to say. Check it out.
I do think that, you know, he is my husband. So I obviously want to honor him and what he's feeling, and he's been going through this life change, and it's mostly about the kids. You know, the kids are getting older. He's very cautious about what we have in the house, and we got rid of, you know, TVs in the kids' rooms and removed makeup from North's room, and he's been very, had this, you know, epiphany of being this, not that he wasn't an amazing dad, but being a little bit more strict as a dad and being very forceful on the imagery that's in our household and what they see, and I actually agree with it, but I'm always gonna be me. Yeah, and so we had that discussion and that fight.
This is coming, of course, after Kanye West declared his born-again status and released a gospel album titled Jesus is King, which has gotten many talking on and offline. All right, so let's dig in, because I'm so excited about this one.
I'm so excited about it.
Kardashian is still looking hot,
yes,
man.
And she's 40 next year, I believe, yes.
Oh, my God.
She is 40 next year. And
hi,
one
Kim.
Bye, OJ. And one thing many people spoke about after watching this interview was the fact that Kim has really grown and come into her own. And it's fantastic to see, because, of course, OJ is always trying to tease her about how she got into the limelight. But I think
her.
It's also nice what she's been able to do with it, no matter what has happened. And
the prison
I thought it was interesting. Yeah. And I thought it was interesting to hear her say, I want to honor my husband. And I'm like, oh, that's not a word you hear often in Hollywood in that situation, in that context. And also, I think it's nice what's happening with Kanye. Some people are saying, get back on your meds and all that. But why I like it, apart from the fact that he's going the spiritual way, it's the fact that it seems to be affecting how
the
he's,
family.
You know, becoming a father, or how he's, how he is as a father. And so they're taking out makeup from their daughter's room.
TV.
They're taking out TVs, and I just hope.
Oh, so I totally agree with you, and I am on the same page with you, Faladili, on this one. I'm super excited about this. I think that Kim and Kanye have grown. You know, I love that growth, especially when people in this climb think that they can copy Americans. They just want to be Western in the way they think and all of this. I want to tell you that there are Americans who still have good head on their shoulder. No. You see them talk about family. You see them talk about, I mean, look at saying that she wants to honor. And when they said Kanye banned the child from wearing certain clothes, that's, you know, and they said, let children be children, for crying out loud. And it goes well with Kim. They're on the same page. You know, when a father and mother are actually taking decisions, because, you know, these days you find out that the mother is saying one thing and the father is saying another thing. And it used to happen in my friend's house.
Yeah.
You know, once their mother talks to them, they know that they can't go to their father because they are always on the same page. And I think it helps in, you know, nurturing,
United
bringing
front.
Up mm-hmm. children. And then again, I watched another clip when Kim was talking about working towards becoming a lawyer. They had so many questions for her. And one of the questions you ask every time, like going back to her past and talking about how she started this, sex tape and all of this. But I tell you what, she has grown. And you know how you constantly fight, that thing about, she's a fine girl, she does not have anything in her head.
And now
she has. People grow.
The prison
change
reform
is the
alone.
Only constant thing. I'm really just happy about the whole thing. I believe Kanye West. I'm a big fan. I believe that is truly a born again Christian.
Right.
And all
he
of this. I can go on and on. I stand.
All right, guys. We're done with the news. And oh gosh, I'll just be after, because there's so much more about
this
story. All right, it's time for a celebrity birthday shout out. Whoop, whoop.
Yay.
Celebrating today are the following people. Yes, New Zealand singer, songwriter Ella Yellick O'Connor, known professionally as Lord, is celebrating today. She turns 23 today.
Happy
and her
birthday.
Debut single, Royals, was a major hit.
Happy birthday! Happy birthday!
I think, what's it called? Royals is by far her biggest, like, I don't know if she's been able to
come with this gothic
look. Yes, and that she's 23.
Like,
She is 23. And gothic look and gothic sound. Yeah. Like,
beautiful. Beautiful.
All right, and also celebrating today, British Nigerian. Honeypot's going to kill me for this. British or Nigerian British rapper, singer, songwriter, and entrepreneur, Patrick Chukwuemeka Okogwu, aka Tiny Temper, is 31 today.
Nigerian British.
Tiny Temper. I like Tiny Temper. Congratulations. Like. Happy birthday, Lord. Happy birthday, Tiny Temper. And happy birthday to everyone else celebrating out there.
Yes.
Today, we wish you all the best. Enjoy and celebrate with caution, okay?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Twitter, where we bring you all the savagery, humor, and craziness happening on social media. Are you guys ready for this?
Yes.
So let's get into it first. Yeah. So Miss Taiwo put up this post, and this is Thierry Henry, shocked. And he says, and she's saying, Jim, 60K. She's the one saying it, though. A Yoruba girl, when a Yoruba boy can break my heart for free, and I will lose weight.
Wait.
So that's not going to the gym that you pay 60K.
There are so many things that can even make you lose weight in this Nigeria.
Share so, with us, Yoruba girl.
Thank you. You are very, very okay with this thing that
My only question is how somebody got Thierry Henry to look like this. This is clutches Brexit.
You're like
Brexit! Jim, 60K.
Just
hey, Yoruba boy, I want to break my heart for free.
Which is not Yoruba. You were saying Yoruba again.
Is that about Yoruba now? So many things.
It's Taiwo that said it.
The traffic in Lagos, waking
can
up.
Make you lose weight.
If you live in, where is it called now? Abule Egba. And you walk on the island.
Yeah.
4 a.m., 3:30 a.m., and then you come back in the night, like almost 11.
And you have
spent half your years on earth on the road. What is now remaining? I'm just saying.
Don't worry. It's Mr. Wood that said this.
Okay.
You're a bad boy that will break
your heart. I'll just keep quiet.
So, dear girls outside, date people like us that will not break your heart.
Okay, so.
Anyways, let's just move on to the next tweet. And somebody put up this post. Afonjai says, every guy started surviving banter since the day they entered GSS1. And somebody now replied, one guy had like 10 Adil Baba t-shirts in the hostel, and one guy said he goes home every holiday to kill his uncles so they can print new polo for the next term. I sure.
What? Yo, like, but then this is so true. Like, the part about how guys learn to survive banter and take a hit early.
Yeah, take it.
Especially if you did boarding school. Like, I did boarding school, I know. And this is so funny that the guy always had a Adil Baba t-shirt. Like, and that's the guy, you always killing your uncles. Like, how do you have 10?
Every time you just be having new Adil Baba t-shirts in secondary school. Boarding house.
I learned how to sustain banter too.
Yeah.
From boarding house.
Boarding school, yeah, for sure. they will roast you. You cry alone, you come back, bounce back alone.
When your mother or parents come and do visiting day, and they don't even bring provision, or they bring one food that's not sweet that you now share with people again.
They will roast you.
Hey God, let's just move on.
How do you eat somebody's food that says it's not sweet?
And you like...
Let's just move on. So, Arsenal fans. Oh, okay. This is...
you're rude.
Sorry, I wanted to go there. This is Toby and somebody from the Big Brother house. And somebody put up this post and it says, you are shouting God. God when. But people are practicing karate in your DM. You know that?
Hey, yes, now I saw it. Yeah.
Hey, so this is a message to
all
those girls.
I am not answering them.
This is a message to all those girls. You are practicing. You are saying, God when. But inside
your
DM.
Your husband is in your DM.
You are fighting the day. Hello.
Foladele reminded me of this like 2 years ago. So I didn't know that, you know, all those requests I had. Like I had like 1,000 requests in my DM. I was not just checking. And Foladele would come back to me that this dude is sent you a message. I said, I did not see it.
It's in request.
When I saw the message, I saw Ushbaby's message telling me about his show, new.
Okay.
Don't show.
Okay.
And I also saw the guy's message. And I also saw so many people's message. I said, hey.
Okay, so how far with that guy now? You replied him, Abby.
Will you face
the
this
one
thing?
She blocked?
No, she replied him.
The one that pestered my life. She didn't reply because he was always hanging in her DMs. She came to meet me. The guy came to meet me. How far? I like honeypot. Hello, friend. It could be a post about like my birthday or something. He will still come there. Greet honeypot for me. Yo, wish me happy birthday or get out of here. I had to block him. So yeah, Moose, whatever your name is, if you're wondering why you haven't replied or rooted on the pod for you, I blocked you because you were pestering my life.
You too.
Thanks. Yeah, I blocked him because he was pestering me.
Dear Nigerian girls, don't be like Nigerian girls.
I answered DMO.
Let's just move on. So this is a picture of a guy, Famzin, the Manchester United coach, and this is himself in a private jet, and he puts Alhamdulillah, like, finally I'm with Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, and somebody puts
a reply.
Somebody now replied, because this is like a Photoshop picture. There's no, you know, my guy did not even get it. Man, you fans, this is what you people do. I don't understand. You don't even get the picture right. You don't Photoshop well. And somebody now replied, probably a Chelsea fan, like, Alam, dude, you lie. Alam, dude, you lie. Not Alam, dude, you lie. Like, you cannot meet this guy.
Dude, you lie.
Alam, dude, you lie.
Look, wait till Musa no go see for gate. Wait till Emeka no go see for spare parts shop.
Wait till Kira Jimenez no go see for movie.
For movie. What did my eye not see on this Twitter street? This is the most, like, it's so clever and wicked in the same breath.
Yeah, but
dear man, dude,
you lie.
Okay, turn your dodo is burning.
Dear Man U fans, I know you guys are not in top 10
can you leave them
in the Premier League right now. You guys can do better. What is this? Is this what you have turned to?
Photoshopping,
but can we move on? Ah, you now sat on this one.
Because of Man U fans, because Chelsea, after two red cards that Shini got, they managed to get.
Moving on!
Oh, yeah, now he moves on.
So, Bella puts up this post and it says, how can you be owing me 157k, 157k, then send 15k? What am I supposed to do with that? Then somebody then replied, 15k sent though. 7k balance coming soon. Be patient with them, please. Do you understand what she did? 15k sent.
157.
Okay,
there you go.
Madam just said 7k balance is remaining, though. It's 157k.
This reminds me of that TSM question you guys had like 2-3 weeks ago about, I think, something about sending. I saw it online.
Oh, when somebody is owing you and sends you something.
Yes, and sends you, mistakenly sends you.
Will you return the money?
Will you return the money? How can you send? Somebody has said, 15 has been sent, 7 is coming, the 7 on top.
But you know, some people can make it very difficult for you to even borrow people money. Yeah. It has happened to me before. So I went to ask this person. The person that was borrowed the money will give me 5K today. And another person sent that person to give me money, to dash me money. The person now said, take it as some of the money that I'm owing you. So, and every day, the person now said, I am your brother. There is nothing you can do to me.
I don't win. I'm sure you have you got to the balance of that money?
What?
If I,
I cried. I don't even know whether I got the whole, and it was my salary that I spent my life.
So let me speak on behalf of this guy. So should he have sent the 15K or just wait till he has enough money?
That 15K is not even anything. It's not anything.
Out of 157K.
What?
So did we have an agreement that you send it back in bits?
And boy, I don't get the full one now.
So
my sister and my brother, the thing that you're taking away from this gist is that the money cannot dash people. Yoruba people will say, don't borrow. So if you know that somebody has asked you for 100K and you can afford to like just give the person like 10K, say, my brother, I don't have about this 10K, just manage it. I mean,
thank you.
My response to your thing is even Yoruba. Like, oh, to
yes.
Like, you're not.
It was Yoruba I wanted to speak to
you. The thing is just because you know how Yoruba can be very expressive.
You see that?
Yes. You cannot. English cannot come close to
what.
But
and you said people have problems for money. Like,
thank
honestly.
You. Thank you so much, OJ. Stick around, guys. E-Splash continues after this break.
All right, guys, moving on the show. Up next is Where Are They Now? So take a look to find out which popular Nigerian artist from way, way back we are talking about today.
It's Where Are They Now? Black Reverends. Afro hip hop group Black Reverends, popularly called Ayangba Boys, started their career as a group in the 90s. The duo Shaibu Adams, Shuktu, and Wasiu Lawal, Wesley, had their first hit song Ayangba Girls in early 2000. At that time, the smash hit single by Black Reverends, Ayangba Girls, was like a national anthem. Most parties and events were not complete without that song. But like a flower that withers, nothing was ever heard about the singers of that hit song again. Though many speculated that the rise of other younger stars and the love for more danceable and fast beat songs faded the Ajegunle stars out of the game. However, the Anyagba girl crooners, Black Reverence, are planning a comeback into the music scene. Though they have few new songs, they're doing their best to win music hearts with their hit single of yesteryears. At a recent event, the group said that they had to split due to a slave contract they signed with their record label back then, adding that this chased them out of the scene for a long time. Now you know where they are now.
Alrighty guys, it is a wrap just like that, but not on the show.
And then we just saw Clarence Peters.
Yeah, we did. Where did you see him?
In the studio.
Yes.
He just passed.
Sorry guys, you have to be in the studio to see him.
Yes.
Sorry.
I'm sorry, but we just saw him, Sha.
Anyway guys, it is a wrap on the first half of the show, but still to come, we have so much more. Yes, we have entertainment news recap, True It Off, Daily Top 5, and Celebrity Top 10 Countdown. So don't go anywhere, because we will see you very soon. We are back, guys, and we hope and trust and believe that you have been loving the show.
Wow, motivational speaker.
Motivational, no, it's Honey Pot. I was trying to use some of the words that is. Anyway, guys, welcome back to Entertainment Splash. So far, we've brought you the news, we've brought you celebrity birthday shout-outs, Rewind, Tweetville, and of course, Where Are They Now? Now it's time to chew it off, where in a minute or less, one of us will vent about what is currently bothering her.
Okay, I'm good.
By the way, you look good, Foladili.
Top it. Yeah. I look sweet in baby pink.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Head to toe.
I look to reach you.
Bye.
You look good, though.
I really like your head thing. Yeah. Your head accessory.
You look like Bob Marley. Do you like it? You look like Bob Marley. You like
That's
it?
That's a legend.
The problem is that you won't say thank you. That's why we don't compliment you anymore.
Thank you. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right. Bye.
That thing almost even, but let me just say they have called me to
What are you ranting about?
So I have like two things I want to rant about. I don't know if I can just break them down.
Very right? Cool. Because...
All right. Thank you. So the first one is I was on Ikorodu Road. I was coming from Maryland side. I mean, I was coming from Surulere, but then I got to Maryland. And you know that new garage, you know? So I saw that a child wanted to cross the road. Do you know, that's new garage, go, where they take buses to Akure and all up to Ife and all those places. So you see how that place, like somebody wants to cross from that side to the other side. You know that there is no bridge, nothing, like no pedestrian bridge and nothing there. I was so scared for this child that I started praying. Like I was looking through my mirror, looking back, like, did he succeed? God, help him. Then I was wondering, how can, I don't know, parents, please. Guardians, please. Children are not meant to be. It was coming from school. If anything happens to him, that adults have accidents, hit and run, and at the end of the day, nothing is done. I mean, for an adult that has miscalculated.
Yeah, talk more about
so a child. How much more a child, please? As in, until I got to where I was going to, I was disturbed. I was greatly disturbed. Then the second one quickly, I was on Twitter this morning and somebody was lamenting about how she went to this hospital and her son was very ill and, you know, they just got to the hospital and, you know, the nurse said that I will not be able to do anything except the doctor is or does anything or gives me the go ahead. Mm-hmm. And they waited and waited. They did not see the doctor. Huh. Only for, after hours, the doctor came and he just came and just came with all the attitude and was not. And so he said, okay, go and buy this, go and buy this. When That's they came, what? Said, go and buy. And this was an emergency case, go and buy. And so when she came back, she said she saw that the doctor was attending to other people that didn't have any emergency case. And somehow, back and forth, the child was already weak and the child died.
Okay.
No, at that point, it was as if they stuck a knife in my heart. Like, what? And so she was on Twitter saying that she's going to take it off, she's going to write petition, and people are saying, young lawyers, you can come out and take this case off and all that. And they said that even at that time, he said he wants to go and pray. He's a Muslim that he wants to go and pray. I'm like, no. Oh. I know that we can be religious.
Wait now. As in the doctor said he wants
yes.
to have... Wait now. In that tweet,
yes.
She said that.
She said so, and I'm saying that, see, if your neighbor is hungry, and you're even a Christian or whatever, and you say that you're taking your tithe to church, give that neighbor that money. God understands, and he likes it. If you want to go and pray, and somebody needs your help, please help the person. Don't say you want to go and pray.
So let me just respond to the first rant. It's so sad and unfortunate that Africa, or let me use Nigeria since I've lived here, is a place where children are forced to grow up quickly in that way, in mm-hmm. that you see kids on the road
yeah.
that early and you're like, and they're begging for money or they're just crossing and, you know, and you're like, where are your parents? And so there needs to, there's something needs to be said because it's something we've ignored for so yeah. long. We've grown up seeing it and it's become a part of us. So I think it's, when we've become desensitized to it, I think it's something we need to talk yeah. about. It's something that, something needs to be done about it. But of course, I don't know, man, I don't know. Then to the second one, Honeypot, I still don't know because we saw that in movies. Ah, if you don't bring money, you can't do anything.
This one is not even about money.
And then, so that one is still a problem. And the next thing, you see that this one even goes deeper and you're telling me that the doctor said he had to go and pray. I need to go check that story out. I don't think I can say much until I see that story.
So I'm going to tag you or whatever, me. Yes.
He went to go and pray.
Yeah, and okay. the child died.
All right, thank you. No words.
Nigerians, steady.
Okay, I will.
All right, guys, very demoralizing, very desensitized we are in this society. But let's move on. Let's just move on to more exciting things. And yes, it is time for a quick recap of the entertainment news. So yes, let's do this.
All right, so we started with Lizzie Evome, aka Ovularia, is not dead.
And of course, Shatta Wale is apparently worth over $10 million.
All right, and lastly, we talked about Kim Kardashian and Kanye West, who have reached compromises over Kanye West's religious beliefs.
Guys, let's know you're watching the show by calling us on the numbers on the screen and tweeting to us at TVC Connect with the hashtag #isplash on TVC. We are on Instagram too with the same handle. We'll go on this break and we'll return. Stay here with us.
We're oh my back. Goodness. Honeypot, your rant has still got us talking in the studio. Crazy, crazy stuff.
I just had to talk about that. Yeah. So I'd already shared that with Foladile. I mean, you saw it now mm-hmm. and it was from the
moment. I'm going to retweet it. For those who are wondering about the story, I'll retweet it. I'll put it on Twitter. All right, guys. Welcome back to the show. Yes, it is still Entertainment Splash. And it's time for Daily Top 5.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Let's go. Hey. All right, guys, let's get into it. Now, when there's so many things competing for our attention. Back in the day, the Nollywood film industry kept many of us glued to our screens. Yes, we might diss the quality and storylines every now and then because now we know better. But let's throw it back to when we didn't know better and this was all we had. Yes, here are 5 evergreen Nollywood movies. I'm so excited for this one. Number 1, Karishika. This was a 1996 Nigerian horror film where a girl named Karishika was sent by Lucifer to the world to kill, destroy, and tempt people in order to increase the population in hell. Actors in this film include Becky Ngozi. I'm sorry, I can't get through it without laughing. Actors in this film were Becky Ngozi, Courier, Bob Manuel Udoku, Sandra Achums, amongst others. It's so funny to me, like the way that it was described.
This was a scary.
Lucifer, King of Demons. Karishika, Queen of Demons.
Scary movie.
Scary. Satan is in trouble. Like, and like at the end of it, there was To God Be the Glory. So it was supposed to win souls and make people get away
from it. So what I remember in this era was that, you know, a lot of people did not have color TV.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, we're just transitioning from all those white and black. And in my house, we did not even have the small one. We had like the, you know, four-legged TV yeah. that you're always, you know, closing, you know, and all that. And I think because of my sight, because I've always been short-sighted, even from, so you know how I go to people's houses and they just have small TV. I will not be able to enjoy what they are doing
yeah.
except they have the big one that we have in my house.
Yeah.
I said it was my childhood friend, Debola, that had the color TV in their house. So I would go and they had home videos. Oh, used to come. So, you know, I would watch Karishika and all that. And it was a thing like, yeah. You have achieved something.
It was a thing. All that. It was cassettes back then that you would, you know, so it wasn't
crazy.
And you had
crazy
the, when, and then later as time progressed, you had something to rewind.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
SMH. Anyways, moving on to number 2 on our list. This one is titled Domitila. Yes, this movie was produced by Zeb Ejiro and told the story of young girls who went into prostitution to survive. It stars Sandra Achums, Enebele Elebua, Maureen Iwua, Charles Okafor, Ada Ame, Kate Enshaw, Basoj Taraya Jr., and Anne Njameze as the title character.
Yeah.
So Domitila 2 was... I liked it.
Yeah, it was.
I liked it because of the storyline.
Yeah, it was widely talked about.
Yeah.
And it was also very star-studded. And that was back when Sandra Atrams was really in our faces. I mean, she was one of the people ruling from the late 90s into the early 2000s. And she was in the first one we talked about, Karishika, as well.
The theme songs always get you, like, you know, with Domitila. And the way they even, you know, advertised Domitila, oh my God.
You must go and watch it.
The promo was... Yes. Mad.
Yes.
If you didn't watch movies like this in those days, you'd be like, you're not informed.
You know, my mom's a pastor, amongst other things. The way she like pushed us away from Domitila back then, like
because
she,
of the storyline.
That silly movie, that nasty movie.
It's okay, watch this, watch this, watch this.
All right,
now. Now it's everywhere.
The
tents
are looking the same.
Oh, wow. This look is just so beautiful. Like, some people are vampires.
Honestly.
All right, Out of Bounds. Let's talk about Out of Bounds.
Yes.
So this film from the 90s featured actors like RMD, Bimbo Akintola, and Ayo Adesanya, amongst others. It received several nominations and won 3 awards at the Nigerian Movie Awards. It was produced by Richard Mofe-Damijo and directed by Tade Ogida.
And this was... Ramzi Nua's, RMD.
RMD, yes.
Yesterday's also. This was his, he wrote it and he produced it. It was his debut and he put out something about that the other time. Yeah. And Tade Ogida, of course, directed it, who's been doing this for a long time. Yeah. And Bimbo Akintola. I also remember the song in the movie, Don't Mess With My
Tutu.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you got another woman. Don't mess up with my tutu.
Yes.
Really nice. Speaking of catchy songs in movies from way back, in evergreen movies, Instakaball is our next evergreen movie we are talking about today. And it told the story of community vigilante boys fighting against criminality like armed robbery and murder cases that put fear and panic in the community. Sam Dede was in this one. Chiwe Taluagu, Pete Ene, and Amechi Muanago were some of the actors in this film. This one went on to like
our action. This was like our action movie. Like,
bruh.
Everything, got plus, everything.
And you know, it was the whole Bakassi boys thing. Yeah. If you reverse that, it, then you get Isakaba. Yes.
Oh, Isakaba is Bakassi.
It's not a direct reverse.
Yeah.
Similar, yeah.
I didn't know.
And the shades, the, you know, head, the thing, yeah, the handkerchief. Ah, it's crazy.
I didn't know.
It was that direct back then.
Okay, wrapping up our daily top 5. Yes, number 5 on our list is the Most Wanted.
Action.
Yes, this movie was about 4 unemployed female graduates who, after failing to get a job, decided to try robbery, disguising themselves as men. They carried out all operations swiftly. The movie starred top Nollywood actors Regina Askia, Ibina Bofibresima, Ayo Adesanya, Genevieve Naji, yes, Liz Benson, and Anta Laniyo. And so I saw this movie. So it was when I watched Set It Off.
Set It Off, thank you,
Jay. Nigerian directors and producers. Like, yes. See where you got inspiration.
Yes, Set It Off. It was a very similar story. You know, 4 girls. Queen Latifah, Jada Pinkett Smith, and then you have them. I had this one, all of them. Regina Askia.
Let me come to their rescue.
But they killed it.
Let me come to their rescue.
Oh, yeah,
it was really good. Under the sun, is there anything new?
There's nothing.
There's nothing new, and we're not even knocking it down.
No,
fair enough comparison. We could tell it was a comparison, but we still
killed it. Like, I had this one in the banking hall, shooting, like, action.
Because, you know, in Set It Off, there was that scene, shooting. Oh my gosh.
Well, they did it well, right?
In case you do not watch these movies, go and search for this movie.
You'd have to call Ojo Bodao. You'd even be calling Ojo Bodao because I don't understand. As some people used to just come and be thinking that saying, quick, Nikon. Wow.
Yeah. Should we move on?
Okay.
Let's move on.
Up next is Celebrity Top 10 Countdown. Let's enjoy the oldies on Yinka Davies Countdown. Yeah. Enjoy this.
Hi, my name is Yinka Davies, and this is the Celebrity Top 10 Throwback. My version. Let's go. Greed and jealousy grew steadily within. We slow. Number 10. This is a superstar celebration jubilation for Rugged Man. Check it out. Out. Okay. Because this is throwback, right? I mean, I don't know. I don't know. There's so many songs, but I'll choose Try Your Love by Third World. One time they didn't let me love the song I wanted to love. That was my number one, but now it's on number 8 because I have to do throwback. Rugged Man's birthday, so I must give him some chicha. Let's do Baraje with him. Come on, people. Move your body, make you shake that thing where you get. Let the music enter your head.
I make her come at you like this. Even if you truly hate the Rugged Man, you can't help but like this.
This song, I put at number 6, is Baba, Olamide Julius. 1983, I think it was, I wanted to cry. I wanted to do everything. I wanted to become, I wanted to serve this, serve that, go to work. So watch it. This is the reason why I wanted to cry because I didn't get to do all the things he did on, you know, in the video. It's shared by Orlando Julius. Check it out. Yes, to honor my friend and colleague, a beautiful person who helped me to do my album that you are about to see later on. Beautiful Nubia, Ikukwa Fo. Please enjoy it. I love it. It's so soothing. Check it out. Onite ba de be e ba mi ki won o gbogbo wa la o fa yo dele e ba mi ki won. Beautiful. I'm still thinking of it. I think it just gives me that feeling, euphoria of that woman, one model like that, Kajanin Sambulera. Come on, let's enjoy Sambulera. Wow. At number 4, I love it because it sounds like 007. I think that's why I like it. Girl with a Gun. If you ask me, Omaumi is on the run.
Heavy for mouth. If you ask me.
My all time. Any day, anytime. I have never. The song, actually, I was sincerely, this is one of the reasons why I didn't see the need to travel anywhere. Anytime I travel out, I want to come back here to come and finish what we started. The name of the song is Toto, 1980, Africa.
She's coming in 12:30 flight. The moonlit wings reflect the stars that guide me towards salvation.
Africa, I love you. Nigeria, I love you. Ah, world, all the continents, I love you all. Well, calm down. I hope you've had a wonderful time with me. This 9. I'm gonna dedicate this one to one of the ladies in, you know, this TVC platform thing. I call her Lush, they call her Beru on News. She loves this song, so, and because it's the song that she's heard me do or something, I decided to give it that number one for me. Owo by Yinka Davis, featuring the great Sikiru Ainde Barista. Thank you very much for enjoying my Countdown Top 10.
Hey, I love you too.